Vitamin C serums can give you smoother, brighter, and younger looking skin because of the antioxidants and collagen boosting properties it gives your face. Not just that, vitamin C serum has the potential to improve your skin's appearance by preventing wrinkling and reducing the appearance of dark spots and hyperpigmented patches around your face. And that's probably the reason why you're using them. In today's video, we'll be going over two of the most popular 10% vitamin C serums on the market. The CeraVe Skin Renewing Vitamin C Serum versus the Roche Posay Pure Vitamin C10. Definitely stay tuned till the end and you'll know exactly which one is better and why you would want to go with that one. I've been getting a lot of questions on different products and I'll be making more comparison videos like this one in the future with a lot more products, and I'm open to suggestion too. So make sure to hit that subscribe button down below to not miss out on future videos. Also, if you learn anything in the video, take 2 seconds to give it a like down below as this really helps out the channel. So to make this video hopefully easy to follow and also easy to refer back to, I'll first start out with what the CeraVe Vitamin C has in common with the La Roche-Posay Vitamin C. Then I'll break them down each into their own respective components, weigh the pros and cons so you don't have to, and then finish it off with my final take. And for full disclosure, guys, I purchased these myself and this isn't a sponsored video, so my review is totally mine. And I think it's great to be transparent about this, so please like the video if you enjoy transparency. Now, these guys are gonna be 10% vitamin C serums, which, as you know, it's that sweet spot for the concentration level vitamin C is between 10 and 20. 10 being a great beginner-friendly level that is just right enough to start off with because it's higher than the 8% for it to produce results. And quick tip, avoid going over 20% vitamin C, which could lead to irritation and doesn't increase its benefits either, which is why you'll see most products use 10, 15, or 20. The form of vitamin C that they are in also matters too. They're both pure vitamin C in the form of L-ascorbic acid, which is the form you want. The other forms like magnesium ascorbyl phosphate or ascorbyl 6-palmitate won't do the work you need. L-ascorbic acid is a highly unstable molecule, however, so it does require a water-based environment like a low pH and antioxidants to increase its ability to really get into the skin deeply because you need it to get in all the way. And these two products ensure all of that. They both contain hyaluronic acid, which will help your skin retain moisture, giving it a plumping effect to combat sagginess. They both have vitamin E, which I always recommend that your vitamin C also has vitamin E. The vitamin E also softens the skin and protects it from damage and helps lock in moisture even further. I like that they both don't use any common allergens, sulfates, parabens, or unnecessary oils. And there's a total of 10 ingredients in both of them that they share in common that are going to work tremendously in anti-aging, brightening the skin, dark spots, and just overall better texture. Oh, and one more thing, because they use L-ascorbic acid, they need great packaging, otherwise they'll just oxidize and change color when exposed to sunlight, which both of them actually do have good packaging in mind. So it's really not an issue with either one of these. Now, let's dive a little deeper on the Vitamin C Serum by CeraVe. This serum feels like a water gel consistency, and I'm very impressed with the fact that this vitamin C is not sticky or tacky, which is a huge plus. It melts nicely into your skin and leaves behind a velvety smoothness, which I absolutely love. It does have a scent to it, not a citrus scent as you would think, but more of a floral scent, which does dissipate quickly, so no issue there. Overall, I am very impressed with it. And there are 3 notable ingredients in it that stood out to me. The first being is that it uses ceramides. And as you know, most CeraVe products incorporate ceramides 1, 3, and 6-2. And ceramides are essentially just lipids found naturally in the skin, and they're there to protect your skin barrier and retain moisture. Especially ceramide 1, as it contains the essential fatty acid, linoleic acid, which plays a binding role in the lipid layers of the extracellular matrix. Basically, think of these ceramides as a waterproofing for the face. The second ingredient is the fact that it uses tocopherol acetate or vitamin E acetate instead of just free tocopherol. And the reason why you see this is because tocopherol acetate can be more stable since then it is converted to its biologically active form vitamin E within the skin when applied topically. So it's one extra step to ensure the vitamin E gets into the skin intact. The third ingredient is cholesterol. And you might be thinking, why is there cholesterol in this product? Well, cholesterol is actually found naturally in the outer layer of the skin. About 25% of the mesh that's between our skin cells consists of cholesterol. So when CeraVe uses it in addition to ceramides, they're targeting a deeper problem that may be causing pigmentation, which is the skin barrier, which I applaud them for. Now let's get into the La Roche Posay Vitamin C Serum. Immediately when applying it, the serum has an excellent consistency. You'll notice it right away when you try it. It's not too thick or runny, and the dropper, if you're not careful, can be a tad messy, but it does help control the amount you use. And you only need to use a dime size amount, since a little goes a long way. But really guys, the serum feels refreshing and weightless on my skin, and it absorbs quickly and doesn't feel sticky. Now, both of these products, let me make it clear, they both don't leave a tacky or sticky residue, and it can layer pretty much weightlessly under a moisturizer or other products. So they both win in that department. Now, there are three ingredients in here that stood out to me as well. The first is, while both of them use hyaluronic acid, the La Roche Posay uses both hyaluronic acid and hydrolyzed hyaluronic acid. Hydrolyzed hyaluronic acid is a low molecular weight, chemically chopped up version which may absorb easier into the skin, which may help keep your skin moisturized longer. The second ingredient is that it also uses salicylic acid as the 27th ingredient. So not a hefty amount, but enough to reap some of the anti-inflammatory benefits, which at the levels in this product can be an excellent way to exfoliate the skin, both on the surface and in the pores. And the third ingredient is the neurosensine dipeptide of tyrosine and arginine as the ingredient. Acetyl dipeptide 1-acetyl ester, which is what really makes La Roche Posay unique. The dipeptide works by stimulating the skin nerve cells to release enkephalin, which, long story short, it's a signal for the skin to relax and relieve pain. And the reason why it's used is so that it can instantly decrease skin irritations coming from heat, chemical stinging, or mechanical stress on the face. This, combined with vitamin C, theoretically can really create the environment on the skin to support vitamin C's brightening and glowing effects, so there may be some synergy there. Now, both of these products are an amazing option when starting off with vitamin C, but no video is complete without going over some things I didn't like about each of them, because remember, this is all about transparency. The only drawback with both is that they both use denatured alcohol, which can irritate the skin if your skin can't handle denatured alcohols. Most people actually don't have an issue with it, and this is just for nitpicking sake. The denatured alcohol in both products is actually a low level of alcohol in the formulation to promote the stability of the vitamin C. It can also help to provide a lightweight feel and quick absorption, making it layerable under a moisturizer. Something to keep note of, the CeraVe also uses isopropyl myristate, which helps reduce the heavy, greasy feel in products with high oil content, but it does have a comedogenic rating of 5, which may clog pores. And the La Roche Posay one contains a fragrance which smells quite nice, but fragrance of any type, even natural, is just as allergic as synthetic. But since it is tested for sensitive skin and no issues were found, means I would spot test it before applying directly to the face, just to double check. And with both products, some say they don't work and they end up stopping it. But you have to remember, vitamin C serums take at least 12 weeks to take effect, because it takes time for new cells to regenerate and for pigment to start clearing. So keep up with it for 12 weeks before you decide on what to do next. You won't believe how many people grow impatient and give up too early. Don't let this be you. But honestly guys, both will do a great job, since they are both heavily tested by dermatologists for sensitive skin. They both will visibly brighten the skin and provide antioxidant protection. They both help to improve skin tone and texture and hydration. You get the vitamin E, the hyaluronic acid with both to retain the moisture. But if I were to pick one, I would go with the La Roche Posay one, as you get a mild exfoliation at the same time, and I liked how it felt on my skin more. Another thing is that I personally like the dropper method to control the amount of serum used too. Be sure though with both guys is that you store it as far away from light and heat as possible. Avoid leaving it near a window or anywhere exposed to direct sunlight, because they will oxidize and go bad. Let me know what your thoughts are down below and what you think. Have you tried any of these? What were your results like? Leave them in the comments below. And like the video if you learned anything, and leave a comment down below if you have any questions as well. I'd be happy to answer them. And until then, I aspire to see you all live your best life, and I'll see you guys on the next one.